going to be an introduction to square roots and radicals. I'll be explaining what those are in just a minute, but let's begin with a review of what it means to square a number. So for instance, we know 0 squared just means 0 times 0, which is 0. Let's skip to something like 3 squared. That would mean 3 times 3, or 9. Let's say we have a number in parentheses squared, like negative 2. That would be negative 2 times negative 2, which is positive 4. So remember, when you're squaring a negative number, it's going to be positive. Let's take a fraction like 5 sixths squared. That would mean 5 sixths times 5 sixths, which is 25 thirty-sixths. Let's take a decimal like 0.4 squared. This would mean 0.4 times 0.4. And so we would do 4 times 4, which is 16. And then we need to move in a decimal place for each of these. So this is going to be 0.16. So for instance, this is just a little review of what it would mean to square a number. And of course, there's infinitely many numbers you can square. I'd recommend knowing up to, let's say, maybe 15 squared of all the whole numbers. So, you know, using your times tables, once you get up to 10 squared, you should know that's 100. 11 squared, 11 times 11 is 121, and 12 squared is 144. Most people know this from your times tables, but let's just do 3 more, which I don't think you'll find too hard. And you don't have to memorize these, but it might be convenient. 13 squared is 169, and 14 squared is 196. Notice you just switched the last two digits from 13 squared to 14 squared. So if you want to memorize those aren't too bad. And 15 squared is 225, 15 times 15. If you don't memorize them, that's fine, but they might come in handy if you do know those. There's a couple more. What about if you have something with zeros at the end? Like, how about 30 squared? That would just be 30 times 30. And just as a reminder, when you have something with zeros, just multiply the 3 times 3, and then you put a 0 for each one in there, so you get 900. So if you have something with more zeros, that's the little trick. So if you have 50 squared, you're just going to do the 5 times the 5, right? Because it's 50 times 50. Which is going to be 25, and then 2 extra zeros. So this is just a little introduction to how to square numbers. Now, let's take a couple of things here. Let's do 3 squared, which we see is 9, and then we're going to do a negative 3 in parentheses squared, so that's negative 3 times negative 3, and notice you also get 9. Now, if you square a number and you get 9, what this means is that that number that you squared is a square root of 9. So what we have is both 3, oops, not very good handwriting, both 3 and negative 3 are called square roots of 9, because when I square them, I got 9. So a number is called a square root of a number if, when you square it, you get that number, right? So both 3 and negative 3 are square roots of negative 9. Now, what if I asked you, what are the square roots of 16? Right? So it's just a question. What are the square roots of 16? You have to think, well, what number, when I square it, will give me 16? And actually, there are two numbers. 4 and negative 4 are both called square roots of 16. Now, here's the tricky part. If you write a symbol that we use for square root, so the square root symbol, looks like this. Okay? And what you do is you put the number underneath it. So now check this out. Square root of 16. You might think, well, what am I going to say the answer to that is? Is it 4 or is it negative 4? Because when I square 4, I get 16. And when I square negative 4, I get 16. So square root of 16 means find the principal square root. Of 16. Okay, all right, so now, well, what's that mean? So the key is, the difference here is that I'm asking for the principal square root. And the principal square root means the non-negative square root. All right, so the principal square root means the non-negative one. So it could be 0, like the square root of 0, or it's going to be a positive number. Okay, so let's go on. So what's the square root of 16? If I use the symbol, so now I'm not just asking you, hey, what are the square roots of 16? I'm actually writing this symbol for the square root. Your answer cannot be negative. That's what it means. So we would only choose the number 4. So when we use this symbol, that means there's really only going to be one answer. So what would the square root of 9 be? You have to think, well, what number times itself is 9? Well, you could use 3 and negative 3, but again, we're using this symbol, so we want the non-negative square root, which is going to be positive 3. So here's the difference, and this is very kind of confusing. So if I say, find all square roots of 81, this would mean, well, 9 and negative 9. And finding all the square roots of 36, you could say 6 and negative 6. But if instead the direction said find the following, and I'm using that square root symbol, so this means the square root of 81, you would just pick 9. And the square root of 36 would just be 6. So it's a subtle difference, but one you sort of have to be aware of. And for the most part, when you're working in algebra, you'll be using the symbol, the square root symbol. So when you take the square root of a number, you will just always choose the positive number, the principal square root, which is non-negative. Just keep in mind that I don't say it's always positive, because if I did say what's the square root of 0, that's 0, and that's not a positive number, but it is non-negative, right? Let's say you were given this problem, evaluate square root of negative 9. You would think, okay, what numbers can I multiply by itself? What number can I multiply by itself and get negative 9? Well, remember when we began, when you squared a number, it was positive? So in general, when you square a number, you're going to get positive. I'm going to be careful here. For all the real numbers, like all the positive and negative numbers, which is all we're working with right here, it's not negative. So what we would say is square root of negative 9 is not a real number. And I'm not going to say there's not an answer, because as you go on in algebra, you'll find out that there is something else, which we'll call a complex number. So we're going to be able to evaluate this later on in some course, maybe not the one you're in right now, but for now, the square root of negative 9 is not a real number. So I want you to try a couple problems now. All right, put the video on pause and try these four problems. All right, here we go. This is the first one, square root of 25. What times itself is 25? 5. All right, next one, negative square root of 49. Now, notice the negative sign is out in front of the radical sign. This symbol, which I call the principal square root, is also called the radical sign. So I'm going to say that that is minus, I'm just going to write the minus sign, and then the square root of 49 is 7. So negative the square root of 49 is the same as negative 7. Square root of negative 64, uh-oh, it doesn't equal any numbers, so instead of writing equal, I'd say is not a real number, because I've got the square root of a negative number. And last one, square root of 9 sixteenths, you're thinking, hey, uh-oh, What's that one? What times itself is 9/16? Well, I'll give you a little hint. If they're what we call perfect squares in the numerator and the denominator, like square root of 9 is 3 and square root of 16 is 4, you just take the square root of the top, which is 3, and the square root of the bottom, which is 4. So this gives you 3/4. And so that's just a little introduction to square roots and radicals. So this symbol here is sometimes called a radical sign, and we'll be working with some other ones that look like this with a 3 in it or a little 4 in this little area, etc.